India Today has exclusively accessed audio recordings between Sukesh Chandrasekhar and Aditi Singh, wife of former Ranbaxy owner Shivinder Singh, and the recordings have made startling revelations. Sukesh posed as government officials and extorted 200 crore rupees, promising favors. Manish Pandey gets you this exclusive report.
A billionaire, an alleged con man behind bars, and phone calls that led to extortion of 200 crore rupees. India Today gets a blow-by-blow account of how a jailed con man extorted 200 crores from a business tycoon's wife. The story started when former Ranbaxy owner Shivinder Singh landed in jail in a case of alleged fraud and money laundering in October 2019. Shivinder Singh's wife, Aditi Singh, was working on getting bail for her husband when she was allegedly approached by con man Sukesh Chandrasekhar on the phone. Chandrasekhar posed as a government official when he established contact with Aditi Singh. He allegedly used voice modulation to change the tone of his voice. The shocking detail, he was allegedly doing all this from prison. India Today has exclusively accessed the audio recordings of Chandrasekhar's conversation with Aditi Singh.
You tell him not to be worried. Tell him to let us do our job. We know what we are doing. Tell him to be relaxed. Tell him to now look forward to come out.
Sir is saying that it is inappropriate to have a meeting in the current scenario with everything that's going all around. And he's saying that don't worry about all of these things. Now we just have to look forward to you coming out and working together.
All the while, Aditi Singh had no idea she was being scammed by Chandrasekhar. Aditi Singh became aware of the con months later after the Enforcement Directorate alerted her. The ED had begun taping Chandrasekhar's phone last year, which led to his arrest in the new case of alleged fraud.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, tell him that his bails are now going to dispose at once in Supreme Court. He needs money about anything. He cannot be anybody more going or appealing anywhere. Tell him that. And also tell him that even in the Suresh Kumar case court, he was about to get bail. But because of anything said that you managed this case, that is the reason we have to dismiss. Please tell him that.
Sir is saying that now your bails will happen now that they're all in one in the Supreme Court. Sir, that please don't worry about the family or me or yourself. We are the government's responsibility, and that we are looking forward to, they're looking forward to starting a new beginning with us. So please don't worry.
The probe agency has submitted 84 such recordings to a Delhi court. Chandrasekhar is accused of extorting 215 crore rupees from Aditi Singh over a year. The new recordings reveal how deep the multi-crore scam ran. With inputs from Manish Pandey, Bureau Report, India Today.
My colleague Tanseem Haider is now joining me live from Delhi on this story. Tanseem, this definitely means more trouble for Sukesh Chandrasekhar, because these audio recordings which we've accessed completely implicate him that he was in fact extorting money, posing as government officials from, of course, extorting money from business tycoons.
जी बिल्कुल पौलमी, ये जो खुलासा हुआ है, क्योंकि ये बातें पहले भी सामने आई थी कि इसने कैसे कॉल स्पूफिंग के जरिए, ये समझना जरूरी है कि आखिर जो कॉल जा रही थी जेल के अंदर से, वो कॉल स्पूफिंग के जरिए जा रही थी, और जो कॉल रिसीव कर रहा था उसको ऐसा लग रहा था कि ये किसी मंत्रालय से कॉल आ रही है। यही वजह है कि इन लोगों ने बाकायदा ट्रस्ट किया कि ये कोई ऑफिसर बोल रहा है जो डील कर रहा है उनके जो एक्यूज्ड हैं उनको जेल से जल्दी छुड़वाने के लिए। तो यही वजह है कि सुकेश चंद्रशेखर ने कॉल स्पूफिंग का इस्तेमाल किया और बड़े बड़े ऑफिसर बनकर लोगों से बात की और पर्टिकुलर इस फैमिली से 200 करोड़ रुपए की जो वसूली की है। तो ये अपने आप में बेहद चौंकाने वाला है कि एक बड़े बड़े मंत्रियों का नाम लिया जा रहा था कॉल स्पूफिंग के जरिए और कई मिनिस्ट्री का के लॉ मिनिस्ट्री का नाम लिया जा रहा था और ये कहते हुए 200 करोड़ रुपए की वसूली की गई। अब ये ऑडियो टेप सामने आए हैं, ऐसा भी माना जा रहा है कि कुछ ऑडियो जो जैकलिन और सुकेश से जुड़े हुए हैं वो भी ईडी के पास आ सकते हैं या ईओडब्ल्यू की जांच में सामने आ सकते हैं। जैसा कि अभी हाल में ईडी ने अपनी चार्जशीट फाइल की है, उसमें ईडी ने ये बोला है कि हमने कन्फ्रंट कराया है नोरा को, नोरा फतेही को और सुकेश चंद्रशेखर को और दोनों से आमने सामने बैठा कर पूछताछ की है। उसकी भी जानकारियां सामने आई हैं जिसमें दोनों ने ये बात बोली है कि उन्होंने किस तरीके से एक दूसरे से पैसे का लेन देन किया, कैसे गिफ्ट लिए गए। ये आमना सामना जैकलिन से भी करवाया गया और नोरा से भी करवाया गया, दोनों से आमने सामने बैठा कर पूछताछ की जा चुकी है।
जी तंसीम, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर शेयरिंग ऑल ऑफ दोस डिटेल्स अबाउट दैट ऑनगोइंग इन्वेस्टिगेशन विद अस। Now, India Today has exclusively accessed the statement of actor Jacqueline Fernandez to the Enforcement Directorate. Jacqueline, in her statement, has revealed that conman Sukesh forged a call from the Home Ministry to get through to Jacqueline's makeup artist and then to Jacqueline herself. Sukesh arranged funds to be transferred to Jacqueline's sister's account and claimed that he worked for Sun TV. Not only that, he claimed that he belonged from Jayalalitha's family. During the questioning, Jacqueline also revealed that Sukesh had gifted her 3 designer bags from Gucci and Chanel and funded loans for her siblings. He also gifted her a horse, 2 Hermes bracelets and diamond jewelry sets. Moreover, Sukesh also gifted her a Mini Cooper, which she had already returned. There's a new twist to Bollywood Congate. Alleged conman Sukesh Chandrasekhar has said he gifted Jacqueline Fernandez gifts worth crores, from diamonds to luxury cars and even loans to her siblings. Here's what we know.
A 200 crore rupees fraud, 2 Bollywood divas and an alleged mastermind. The multi-crore scandal gets murkier with every new revelation. The Enforcement Directorate is unraveling a web of lies and deceit, and their latest charge sheet against conman Sukesh Chandrasekhar proves that all that glitters is actually gold. Sukesh has claimed he gifted Jacqueline luxury items worth crores, and the list is long and sparkling. The conman says he gifted the Sri Lankan actor 15 pairs of earrings, bangles and rings from Cartier and a bracelet from Tiffany & Company. Jacqueline allegedly received 5 Birkin bags from Sukesh. Bags for this luxury brand cost anywhere between 30 lakh rupees to 4 crores. Sukesh also sent gifts from Chanel, Gucci and Rolex watches her way. The charge sheet says Sukesh gave the Fernandez family a fleet of luxury cars. A Mini Cooper to Jacqueline, a car she claims she returned, a BMW X5 for the diva's sister in the US, a Maserati and a Porsche to Jacqueline's parents. That's not all. The conman doled out loans worth 1.13 crore and 37.8 lakh rupees to Jacqueline's siblings living abroad. In a statement to the ED, Jacqueline confessed to visiting showrooms of luxury brands to identify products and sending a list of them to Sukesh, who paid and got them delivered to her either directly or through one of his aides. The actor has been stopped from leaving the country and has been questioned 4 times by the ED. However, she maintains that she's only testifying as a witness. With Arvind Oja and Munish Pandey, Bureau Report, India Today.
Dancing diva Nora Fatehi, who was also grilled by the Enforcement Directorate, claims that she received expensive gifts from conman Sukesh Chandrasekhar. Nora has said that she is a victim in the case. From top Bollywood chartbusters to special appearances in films, Nora Fatehi is no stranger to limelight. Here's a look at her Bollywood stint.
She's one of the most popular celebrities on social media. Fans can't get enough of her sizzling dance moves. in all her glamorous avatars, ruling the hearts and minds of Bollywood buffs. The exotic actor Nora Fatehi is under ED lens in the Sukesh Chandrasekhar Leena Paul laundering case. But who really is Nora Fatehi? A Canadian dancer and model who's appeared in several films in Bollywood and South Indian films. Nora began her career after debuting with Roar, Tigers of the Sundarbans in 2014. She was soon signed for a dance track in Puri Jagannath's Telugu film Temper. Her swelt moves and on-screen presence were loved by fans, and she was flooded with offers for dance numbers down south. Nora also had a stint at the Big Boss house in its 9th season as a wildcard entry, after which she became hugely popular with Indian audiences. Nora, however, made her mark in the Hindi film industry after she danced to the remix of Sushmita Sen's iconic song Dilbar in Satyameva Jayate. The song was a rousing success, raking in over 1.1 billion views on YouTube. The song catapulted Nora into near superstardom. She further went on to dance to another Peppy track, including Kamaria from Stree. Nora had a super successful 2019 as she gave two blockbuster songs and was even dubbed the queen of remixes. She signed an exclusive artist deal with record label T-Series in February 2019 and then danced to Osaki from the John Abraham starrer Butler House. The song crossed 26 million views within just 3 days of its release thanks to Nora Fatehi's belly dancing ability, which left audiences awestruck. She then performed in another Hindi classic, Ek To Kam Zindagani from Marjawa. The song became an instant rage on the internet and garnered over 39 million views in just 6 days. Nora then went on to sign her major Bollywood film, Street Dancer 3D, alongside Varun Dhawan and Shraddha Kapoor. Nora managed to leave a lasting impression in what was her first major role, and the track Garmi from the film certainly managed to raise the temperature and already has more than 289 million views. Nora was last seen in Ajay Devgan's Sanjay Dutt starrer Bhuj, The Pride of India, in which she played the role of a spy. Entertainment Bureau, India Today.
Sukesh Chandrasekhar, a conman who is currently lodged in a Delhi jail, is back in news after the Enforcement Directorate seized his luxuriously facing bungalow in Chennai. The conman is accused of running an extortion racket worth 200 crore rupees from inside the Tihar jail. Here's a report.
A bevy of high-end cars. A swanky sea-facing villa. A walk-in closet filled with top designer clothes. Shoes and sunglasses. This sprawling property belongs to India's millionaire hustler, Sukesh Chandrasekhar. Chandrasekhar, a seasoned con man with over 20 cases of fraud worth 200 crores, is currently in a Delhi jail. His partner, Leena Paul, a co-accused in the swindling case, is an actor who played a part in John Abraham starrer Madras Cafe. Sukesh would target rich businessmen, promise to resolve all pending government agencies' cases against them in return for crores of rupees. During the course of investigation, the Enforcement Directorate received a tip-off about Sukesh's Benami property in Chennai, this sprawling seaside villa. The probe officials were stunned as soon as they entered the bungalow. This is what they found inside. A mini bar made of gold line with premium liquor brands. a private movie theater with a Versace rug, and a personal popcorn making machine. Valuable sculptures worth crores of rupees. Golden walls and motifs added to the interiors of the house. With dim lighting on the low-hung ceilings. Chandeliers seem to be a hit with this rogue couple. Lavish bedrooms with fitness equipments were also a part of Chandrasekhar and Leena's lifestyle. Sukesh earned all this by just dialing numbers from inside his jail cell.
Sukesh was using a technology called spoofing of caller ID, and this is why it took more than an year for the officials to detect that it was Sukesh Chandrasekhar who was behind this grand scheme of extortion. But once he was exposed, all his dream came crashing down.
To run his shady scheme without any hindrance, Sukesh had recruited senior officials of the Delhi's Rohini jail, banker Komal Poddar, vice president of RBL Bank, and a few others to collect the extorted money.
Sukesh Chandrasekhar is into criminal activities since he was just 17 years old. In the recent case, he extorted more than 200 crore from a businessman's wife. Another victim has come forward saying that he was also extorted for crores of rupees. Sources say that in last 1 year, when he was in Rohini jail, he may have extorted 3 to 4 other victims. Munish Pandey in Delhi for India Today.